On Bishop Barra's YouTube channel, you will find exclusive content to uplift your faith. The Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo. Live meetings from Bishop Barra Fonseca. Testimonies, thoughtful advice, prayers, and much more. Do you like it? Then subscribe today and share the videos on your social network. You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
May the light of the gospel, that is the image of the invisible God, may be revealed to you and in your life. So, may the light of the gospel, the understanding of the Word of God, of the Holy Scriptures, that is the image of God, which reflects the image of God, may it reflect in your life, may it enlighten your eyes, your spiritual eyes. Because many people, unfortunately, they even hate me. Maybe I'm speaking to someone who is listening to me right now, and they hate me. They hate my voice. They hate my person. They hate me. They hate me. However, they never saw me personally. They never spoke with me. Never. They don't know anything about me. However, they hate me. They hate me really. Really bad. Why? It's not that these people hate me, but they hate the word of God that comes out of my mouth. So they don't even know that they are hating God himself. It's not that I'm God, no. But when I preach the word of God, when I teach the word of God, and people hate me, and the truth is, they are hating the one who spoke the words that I am repeating. Isn't that something good? Well, not good, it's sad, but this is the reality. You don't know me. You've never been with me. You have never even complimented me, nor have we exchanged looks, but you hate me. Why? Because deep down inside, the root of the problem is that you don't hate me. You don't hate me because you don't know me. You hate the words of God that reflect the image of God, and they're spoken through my mouth and they reach your ears. So you hate me because of this. Because you hear the word of God, and the word of God is contrary to those who do what is good, you know, those who are correct, those who are of God. The word of God, the word of God, when it's hidden from people's understanding, it is because the word of God was not revealed to them. The will of God wasn't revealed to them. Look here what the Holy Spirit, through the Apostle Paul, allows to reach us an understanding what God speaks to in regards to those who are unbelievers, those that unbelievers, and they don't even know why. Sometimes they say they don't believe in God, and they will say, oh, because if God exists, there will not be so many people dying from hunger. Children dying of hunger, innocent people being mistreated, destroyed, being killed, and so forth. If this world was of God, If God were to exist, wouldn't he have fixed this situation? And this is the truth. Many people consider themselves atheists because of this. But this is not the truth. It's not the reason why. And we're going to see why what the Holy Spirit speaks to us through the Apostle Paul. Let us read here. It says like this. But even if our gospel is veiled, so what is the gospel? The gospel is good news. It's the good news. Gospel means good news. It means good news. So if the news of heaven, of the kingdom of God, is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. So these good news, news of God, news of heaven, they're veiled for those who are perishing, for those who don't want anything with God. It is for those people who literally hate God. They don't like the things of God. So for these people, the kingdom of God, the gospel is veiled. And it says, whose minds, the God of this age. Who is the God of this age? It's the devil, it's Satan. Lucifer is his name. Him and all his legions of demons. So whose minds, the God of this age, has blinded, obstructed the understanding of unbelievers. For what? Why? Who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, which means the gospel, the light of the gospel is the image of God. The light of the gospel is the image of God. Is the image of God revealed to those who believe, not to those who don't believe. To those who believe, heavens is open for them. But for those who don't believe, heaven is closed. Why? Because the spirits of this world, the gods of this world, have blinded the understanding of people. So you that are listening to us right now, and you listen to us, just to evaluate and to weigh my words, just to analyze what I say. I know I have discernment that you don't want anything to do with God. You are someone who is completely denying and doesn't want the things of God, or to seek what we teach. You are in the objective of seeking reasons to contradict, not me personally, however, the word of God. If you are doing this, my friend, you are fighting against the goats. You're not going to reach anywhere, and you're going to die in your sins and your iniquities. And there will be no hope for you, because after you die, there's no hope. But for those who believe, the gospel is the light, of the Lord Jesus, is the light of God, is the light of the Almighty, for those who believe, who begin to have, or they receive, because of this light, the image of the Almighty. So when we believe in God, my friends, we have to believe in His Word. We are believing in His Word, because we don't see God. We don't feel God. We don't touch God. However, when we read and we observe, absorb, and we hear His Word, we accept His Word, we believe it, and we obey it, then the light of the gospel, the light of the Almighty shines in us, and we also become lights of this world. Praise God.
I was very empty. I was empty. I was fearful. There was this void that I have inside, which I go to the parties to fill that void. I used to party a lot. I go to party every week. I go out with friends, do everything just to fill that void. But after I leave that party, reach back home, the void was still there. So that didn't really help. I heard about the Universal Church from someone who started to attend the church, and they gave me an invitation and invited me to come. They teach me about the chain of prayers. And so I started to do chain of prayers for my family and myself too. There was a fast of Daniel going on, and I do the fast of Daniel, and I was seeking for the pastor always preach about to receive the Holy Spirit. And it doesn't make no sense you're in the church and you don't have the Holy Spirit. So I always want to have the Holy Spirit because it's God living inside of me. So it was hard for me. It wasn't easy. Yes, it was very hard because it was 21-day fast, and I love basketball, and it was a season for basketball. And I have to sacrifice that, not watching that, because I stopped watching the TV, stopped going on media, cut off everything in order to seek the Holy Spirit. So I was seeking for the Holy Spirit, seeking, and I received the Holy Spirit. I know I received the Holy Spirit because there was a big difference, big changes in my life. I just have that, I just feel that confidence. I feel different inside. That void was not there anymore. Things that I used to do, I'm not interested in doing it anymore. I used to gamble a lot, and I don't do those things again. I don't have no urge to do those things, because since I received the Holy Spirit, everything changed. I feel good inside. The Holy Spirit is the greatest blessing that I've received. But when you have the Holy Spirit in you, you become a different person. It's just like what used to matter you, it doesn't matter you anymore. What used to worry you doesn't worry you anymore. You just have that peace within, that joy within. He's just a different person. I just feel happy. I'm just happy all the time. The secret is when you started to come to the Universal Church, whatever the direction the pastor passed to you, you ought to be obedient, because he's not saying that on his own. He's speaking because the Holy Spirit is speaking through him to deliver the message to us. So we ought to be obedient. And as long as we be obedient and do as follow, we will see results. The depression, no more depression. I don't know what that name is anymore. I'm happy now.
When you need some love, I was there the first time that you prayed, and I heard all the promises you made. And when you fell before me, crying, "Father, I have sinned," I picked you up and held you close again. You will always be a child in my eyes. And when you need some love, my arms are open wide. And even when you're growing old, I hope you realize you will always be a child in my eyes. You will always be a child in my eyes. And when you need some love, my arms are open wide. And even when you're growing old, I hope you realize you will always be a child in my eyes. You will always be a child.